Hello and welcome back to Shakespeare. We're still working on Measure for Measure, and we get to hear from Angelo today at the end of Act 2, Scene 2. So, fun stuff. Claudio has been condemned to die by Angelo, who is enforcing laws that haven't been enforced in forever. Claudio asks Lucio to get Claudio's sister, Isabella, to go talk to Angelo to plead for leniency with him, and she does. And the interesting bit about this is, you know, Angelo likes to be so virtuous and so pious and all that sort of thing, and Isabella is a nun. She's, well, this close to being a nun. She hasn't quite taken her vows yet, but we got to see a little smidge of her in the abbey and at the convent, whichever you want to call it. And she was a little bit annoyed that the rules there were not more strict than they are. So she is just as virtuous, just as pious as Angelo. And yesterday she was, you know, giving him a hard time and saying, she was making a lot of good arguments that made sense and fell into like a biblical realm and a logical realm. And they were just, they were really good arguments. And it started to, it actually started to turn Angelo on a little bit. And finally, he tells her to come back and talk to him tomorrow, anytime before noon, which is interesting because he had said that Claudio has to die at 9 o'clock in the morning tomorrow. So we don't know exactly what that is all about. But anyway, he tells her to come back tomorrow and she's like, oh, I will bribe you with whatever. And he's like, bribe me? And she's like, yes, I will pray for your soul and you'll have all the heavenly, you know, backup needs, all that sort of stuff that you might possibly require. I'll pray for that for you. And he's like, oh, okay, sure, thanks. Okay, come back tomorrow. And she's like, yes, I will. She and Lucio say that they're gonna come back tomorrow. And as she is leaving, she says, save your honor. And they leave. And he says, from thee, even from thy virtue. What's this? What's this? Is this her fault or mine? The tempter or the tempted, who sins most? Not she, nor doth she tempt, but it is I that, lying by the violet in the sun, do as the carrion does, not as the flower, corrupt with virtuous season. Can it be that modesty may more betray our sense than woman's lightness? Having waste ground enough, shall we desire to raise the sanctuary and pitch our evils there? Oh, fie, 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 what dost thou? Or what art thou, Angelo? Dost thou desire her foully for those things that make her good? Oh, let her brother live. Thieves, for their robbery, have authority when judges steal themselves. What? Do I love her? That I desire to hear her speak again? And feast upon her eyes? What is't I dream on? O cunning enemy, that to catch a saint with saints dost bait thy hook. Most dangerous is that temptation that doth goad us on to sin in loving virtue. Never, never could the strumpet, with all her double vigor, art and nature, once stir my temper. But this virtuous maid subdues me quite. Ever till now, when men were fond, I smiled and wondered how. Dun, dun, dun! So Angelo is very much in love with Isabella, and he is in love with her because she is so pure and good and virtuous and all of these things, which is maybe a little gross that he wants to do unpure and unvirtuous things to and with her now because of that, is basically what he's saying. You know, he is always, in his last couple lines, he always wondered why men were attracted to women. And now he knows, because he is so, so attracted to Isabella, and he is attracted to her because she is good. So an interesting position to be in. She just wants her brother's life. He now wants her. Where do we think this might go? It's fun material for a comedy, right? Anyway, that's the end of Act 2, Scene 2, and we will find out what things develop in this as we lead towards a really awkward would you rather conversation that is the heart of this play. I will see you tomorrow for more. Mwah.